And I would not be here tonight. We would not be together.
A bunch of racist hypocrites.
For young people in the US, politics is pretty hard to avoid right now.
I feel like at the moment, the political climate in the US is definitely very tense. With everything going on recently, like the assassination attempt on Trump, it's definitely made the divide between Republicans and Democrats more apparent.
And then President Biden dropped out.
Dealing with everything we have to do with.
I really don't know what he said at the end of this.
I think that the majority of Americans want a leader who is competent.
You ever watch the left? She's crazy.
I think a lot of voters are looking at Trump and seeing and just saying, hey, this is the projection of confidence that I want in the office. I think for surprising, it's just been about how many friends I have that aren't usually in tune with this stuff, being so in tune.
A key development in Donald Trump's campaign for president today.
I do believe it's a miracle.
And all the way over on the other side of the world, young Aussies are having similar conversations.
Have you been hearing a lot about American politics lately?
Quite a bit, yeah, a lot.
On TikTok, on Instagram, on the news, everywhere. I think it's just like really crazy that Trump got shot because I don't think anyone would go that far because they don't want him to be president.
I'm interested to see what's happening, and a lot of people would be interested since Australia is such a diverse country. We have people from all over the world, including America.
I think it'll affect decisions made on the country, no matter what way it goes. It'll be a bit scary to see where it leads.
American politics is just entertainment at this point. That's one opinion I've heard quite a bit, and I can kind of see where it comes from, yeah.
But why do so many Australians care about US politics?
I think partly because it is fascinating, you know, particularly in the last few weeks, it has been absolutely wild. But I think, you know, more generally speaking, I guess people understand that what happens in the United States matters.
And it really matters to Australia because we've been pretty good mates with this influential global superpower for a while now. And a lot of that friendship's been based around security. Australia and the US fought side by side in World War II, and when our government believed there might be an invasion, the US answered the call and sent troops to help. But the relationship really became official when we signed the ANZUS Security Treaty in 1951.
Which lots of people actually think means we have a security guarantee from the United States, like they'll come and rescue us if anything happens. But it's not that at all. It's just a commitment, I suppose, to act and support each other.
Since then, we've joined the US in major wars. We have Pine Gap, a joint security base in the Northern Territory, and the AUKUS nuclear submarine deal. The US is also seen as the most important economy in the world and one of our most important free trade and investment partners. It also helps that our countries share similar cultures and values, and American influences are all around us. So it makes sense that decisions made over there really can have an impact over here, especially when it comes to who's in charge and what their policies are around global issues like climate change, immigration, security, and their diplomatic relationships with other countries.
I think also there are cultural implications for Australia as well, because so much of Trump's agenda is around social and cultural stuff, what they call an anti-woke agenda. And you can see, I think, in Australia that the same kinds of politics, the same kinds of positions are being encouraged.
We seem pretty far away, but we're actually very connected with America, and it could really affect a lot of things that happen here, like trade or migration and stuff like that.
Trump's side of supporters, the more right-leaning, traditional people, they'll become a louder majority or minority, and you might see that get pushed into our politics as well.
Different presidents will change things, and Australia might not agree with that as much as they currently do, so America might make a decision that we don't agree with and we might be like, nah.
That picture of America being this huge, big country of like, you know, this is where dreams are made, that perception is dying out a lot more, at least within the younger generation of people.
As for what young Americans think of this diplomatic relationship, well, we might have to work on that.
I don't know much about the relationship between the US and Australia.
No, sadly not. I low-key wish that like people here knew that much about other countries though. Because like I would love to say that we're like like globally, like in tune with a lot of stuff, but like we're just not.
I think that it's good to be able to have a country where we can trust their government and they can trust ours. So I think that definitely the closer the better.
Cheers.